Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I am from Scotland, having a wonderful time here. Thank you. And the great thing about being in your country is that you understand me, which is magic, because the Scottish accent doesn't always travel so well, as I discovered once on a family holiday in Florida. I was there with my wife, my three kids, and I went to buy ice creams for the children, plural. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they got one each, because when I'm on holiday, the special wallet comes out. And the young girl that was serving me, when she finished serving me, she pointed at me and she said, "Excuse me, are you German?" I said, "No." I said, "We're Scottish." And she said, "Oh, I always get you two mixed up." I said, "Well, we speak English. It's an old Scottish habit of ours." Said, "We always speak the language of our most recent oppressor." Yeah. But I said to her, "We are taking the precaution of learning German." Yeah. "Deshalb habe ich entschieden, Deutsch zu lernen," I said to her, which regrettably went right over her head, because this young lady was not a student of languages. Nor, indeed, was she a student of geography, folks, because when she learned we came from Scotland, she said, and I quote, "Oh, did you travel here by train?" I said, "Oh, aye, the old 9:30 Glasgow to Orlando." "What a tunnel that is." No, we flew, and I think it's a kind of obligation to talk about flying. I've got a great tip for you, folks. If you're ever flying, and you can pick whatever seat you want, it's row one, seat C. Because when you land, you're first to get your bag out the overhead locker, and you're first off the flight, and the power that gives you is phenomenal. Because when you're first off an aeroplane, you can take the rest of the passengers wherever you want. 3 times round terminal one, 250 people following me saying,